Our brain is a complex marvel. While we do everyday things such as eating, playing or walking, our brains process an unfathomable amount of information in a single second. Let's compare. A billion computers would take 25 times longer for this amount of data. Yet brain disorders such as Alzheimer's are increasing. Roughly 36 million people suffer from this disease worldwide. In 20 years, this number will double. Getting a better understanding of the brain in order to treat diseases more effectively, this has become Wiesław Nowinski's goal in life. The Polish-born scientist lives and conducts his research in Singapore.
If a doctor helps thousands of patients, and a researcher can help thousands of doctors, then doing medical research is the most rewarding job. I believe that our two most valuable gifts are time and brain. So I use my time to work on the brain.
The brain is highly sensitive and complex. Damage to even the smallest part of the neural network in the brain can have devastating and often deadly effects. Nowinski has developed a technology that helps doctors diagnose and treat brain disorders.
I create atlases or maps of the human brain and invent new ways how to apply them for diagnosis, treatment, prediction and medical education.
Nowinski's atlases are three-dimensional. They are comparable to a navigation system in a car. Just as GPS alerts the driver about obstacles on the road, affected areas in the brain can be detected more easily with Nowinski's three-dimensional map.
The three-dimensional brain atlas contains 3,000 pieces, many more than a typical scan. So what we do, we take this atlas and we map it on patient-specific data, and the atlas identifies and localizes structures. So we can point to any location, and the atlas tells us what's the name. In diagnosis, we compare the corresponding structures in both hemispheres, and we are looking for statistical differences.
It was 20 years ago when Nowinski discovered his passion for the human brain. As a computer design student, he was leafing through a medical atlas and was not at all impressed with its depictions of the brain.
When I looked at those atlases many, many years ago, I thought that those atlases are too limited and we have to create a new generation of holistic atlases which is fully three-dimensional.
In order to do so, Nowinski began by using previously existing brain scans. But the result was disappointing. The image quality was quite poor, and the details could not be recognized. He wanted high-resolution images of the brain from an MRI. But how was he to get those? Nowinski had an idea.
To build the world's most advanced and most beautiful brain atlas, I needed an excellent brain specimen. I couldn't use someone else's brain because it might be not available, and also there is some risk associated with multiple and intensive brain scanning. Fortunately, my brain looks young and fresh, so it's heavenly use. So I keep rescanning it, and I am so happy that my brain can serve the humanity.
So when you look at these three-dimensional pictures of the brain, you're actually peeking directly into the inventor's head. The next step was to assemble the collected data with a computer, like piecing together a puzzle. Every piece has its place.
The virtual brain is like a three-dimensional puzzle or a pyramid. I need a huge amount of data and enormous time to process it. For instance, one scan contains 20 million pixels. So to solve the problem of complexity, I converted the dissected scans into surfaces. And as we have 3,000 surfaces, each piece of the puzzle has to be compressed to make the atlas affordable, even on a tablet.
But even this result was not clear enough for the perfectionist. He wanted details such as nerves, blood vessels, and cerebral regions to be more recognizable and distinguishable from one another. Then his family came to the rescue.
I wouldn't be here today without a great support from my family. My daughter Marta provides lots of advice. My second daughter Natalia, she has designed aesthetically 8 user interfaces. With my wife, they helped me in Atlas coloring to make it very beautiful. So this is a family business.
Novinsky and his team entered the data from over 1,000 patients with brain dysfunctions into the software. Within the course of 17 years, they developed 33 different brain atlases with up to 2,000 individual pictures. Depending on the focus, there is an atlas for each individual field, such as for the vascular system, but also for diseases such as Parkinson's, Alzheimer's or stroke.
The biggest challenge was to make the complex simple and realistic, and to propose novel ways of atlas used. To achieve that, I had to build bridges between science and medicine.
To date, these links have brought Novinsky over 50 patents. Today, he manages 4 high-tech medical companies in Singapore. Over 1,000 surgeons around the world now work with the atlas he has developed. For his life's work, Vislav Novinsky has now been nominated for the European Inventor Award, the Oscar of Technology.
I am very grateful to the European Patent Office for noticing my work. This great honor motivates me to work harder, almost 24/7. And this 24/7 is my destiny because I was born on the 24th of July. I wish that my work will inspire the young generation of innovators in Europe.
At this year's ceremony in Berlin, we will find out if Novinsky wins the award.